Hello Sagittarius, this is Inspire 2016 with your weekly tarot reading for the week commencing the 5th of June until the 11th of June 2017. The first card for you is representing, how do you feel about yourself? Your card is the Page of Swords. You just cannot wait to get started on a new project or an idea, and to share that with others. You start all new projects, ventures and journeys with a huge amount of energy and excitement. The challenge, however, is whether you can keep it up. As with all pages, the beginning always looks promising, but something else is needed in order to maintain the pace. There are always going to be challenges with whatever option you choose, and not everyone is going to be happy with your choices, but when it comes down to it, you need to follow your passions and go where your true energy lies. This page encourages you to move forward and to get the wheels in motion, despite any challenges or setbacks that may potentially stand in the way. This card shows you as a young and idealistic person, with lots of plans and ideas for the future. At this moment, you feel as though you could do almost anything. As a page, you are just beginning to make your way in life, and it is important that you align with others who will not overwhelm you or stifle your direction and ideas. Instead, seek to align yourself with people who will nurture your ideas and will help you to manifest them in an organized manner. Choose a relationship that feels natural, with someone who will learn and grow along with you and give you a chance to develop your own personality and expression. You have an intelligent and sensitive nature, and you may suffer a lot if there is no outlet for your ideas and feelings. The Page of Swords has the ability to find out the truth regarding all matters by asking all the important questions. However, he lacks experience and maturity, so his questioning and probing may become annoying to others as he constantly asks why. Nonetheless, he has both mental and physical agility and is full of anticipation, making him an avid learner and an excellent student. The Page of Swords is also all about communication, information and ideas. This card is an indication that you need to appreciate and communicate ideas, information and theories. These ideas, information and theories may be your own or someone else's. It does not really matter, so long as you are involved in talking, sharing and conversing with others about these ideas. You are always coming up with something new and then finding someone to share it with. You also have a way with words, being a good writer or speaker, and you are passionate about what you are doing. However, be careful that you do not engage in gossip. While this page loves to talk and to be in the know, it is important that you use this talent to benefit others, rather than to create negativity. You may also want to be careful about what you say to whom, as you may be more prone to sharing confidential information about yourself. So, protect your privacy. And you may need to first ground your thoughts, before speaking, in order to ensure that you do not later regret what you have said. The second card for you is representing, what do you want most right now? Your card is the Page of Pentacles. What do you want most right now is the beginning of a new project or venture. Now is the time to start acting on all of those grand ideas and concepts that have been brewing in your imagination. Now is the time to make them real. You need to grow and expand in a way that generates prosperity and wealth for the future. You are just at the beginning of a new project or venture that will require you to remain focused on tangible outcomes and results. Be clear on what skills and resources you will require in order to draw wealth and abundance to you. The Page of Pentacles has the desire to learn all things. He is dedicated to knowledge and the attainment of wisdom and new skills. He is devoted to all in which he is engaged, and he has great concentration in his interests and pursuits. Thus, the appearance of this card suggests that success will come to you after you have mastered new skills and have set your mind to achieving specific, tangible goals. You may need to consider further study, expanding your skill sets at work, or learning completely new ways of doing things. Do not be afraid to be the apprentice again, even if you are a master of another domain. Think of those 70-year-olds who enthusiastically start a university degree. The more skills you bring to your portfolio, the more goals and dreams you can achieve. Sometimes, the Page of Pentacles can represent a young person who has an entrepreneurial spirit. This person may be eager to attain wealth by pursuing a new business idea, by learning new skills, or by applying themselves to a new situation. This page might be young, but there is also great enthusiasm, commitment, dedication, and a strong sense of responsibility to see the project through. The third card for you is representing your fears. Your card is the Eight of Cups. You may be feeling confused about where your best options lie. Part of you wants to explore new horizons and possibilities, but another part of your fears that in doing so, you will miss out on what your current circumstances have to offer. The Eight of Cups also represents knowing when to walk away from a situation that is ultimately not working for you. Even though there are some fundamental issues that have not been resolved, you know that no matter how hard you try, these will probably never be resolved. It hurts you to have to walk away with this lack of closure, but you know this is what is needed right now. Sometimes, however, there may be a lack of commitment to walking away, whereby one day you are ready to leave and by the next day you are having doubts and wanting to stay. The Eight of Cups can reflect helpless, aimless drifting from one place to the next by someone who cannot stand to be confined to just one setting, or someone who never quite fits in. You may fear intimacy and have difficulty making and keeping your commitments. When things become too difficult, you quickly escape and leave behind your troubles, rather than dealing with them head on. The fourth card for you is representing what is going for you. Your card is the Five of Cups. This card reflects a person who is caught up in the past and unable to move on, missing out on new opportunities. Bitter memories from the past continue to bother you, and often a great deal of the blame for past actions is placed on yourself and your inadequacies. To some, it would seem that there is no way out of this situation, but the tarot always shows problems on one hand and solutions on the other. Forgiveness and the ability to recover after emotional loss are necessary. If you are feeling disappointed by another person's actions, and then find it within your heart to forgive that person, releasing yourself from the disappointment. You may also need to reassess your expectations that have led you to this disappointment. Were you expecting too much? Remember, too, that hindsight is much clearer than foresight, and present-day wisdom is gained from the mistakes of the past. Reflect on what led you to this point and understand what important lessons you can take from the experience. Even when things go pear-shaped, there is always something positive that can be gained by reflecting on the lessons learned. While it is true that much has been lost, There is still a ray of hope because some of the cups in this card remain full and upright. You must not pity yourself when you find yourself in his situation. Instead of looking at the situation from a glass's half-empty perspective, look at it from a glass's half-full perspective. The fifth card for you is representing what is going against you. Your card is the Five of Pentacles. You are afraid of experiencing a major financial loss or job loss. If money becomes the primary motivating force in life and the gauge by which you judge your worth, the lack of it may produce anxiety and a sense of being excluded from the good things money can provide. For example, if you are unfortunate enough to encounter financial difficulties such as the loss of employment or an investment gone belly up, you may fall into the trap of losing faith in your ability to recreate a positive financial situation for yourself. Therefore, you should not only consider your actual financial circumstances but also your attitudes toward money. What fears do you have around money and wealth? Are you anxious about never having enough, or do you have faith in your ability to manifest what you need to live a prosperous, fulfilled life no matter what your circumstances? Often wealth is based as much on your psychological state as your actual financial state. You may find new sources of income, a new job, or someone has offered to help you out while you get back on your feet. You may be starting to feel as if life is worth living again and starting to regain your self-confidence. Finally, you can see a way out of your financial difficulties and your hope is being renewed. The Five of Pentacles can sometimes indicate the persistence of inner, spiritual poverty. It reflects a time when you feel isolated and alone, even if surrounded by many people. You may feel as though something is just completely out of place and you are struggling to place your finger on what it is. Return to the Four of Pentacles and you may come to realize that you have placed too much emphasis on your material wealth and have neglected your spiritual well-being. The last card for you is representing the likely outcome that you may have. Your card is the King of Cups. You are emotionally balanced and controlled. You have a very deep understanding of your feelings and emotions, and are able to connect with this when necessary. As you deal with some of the scenarios that life throws at you, draw on this deep emotional maturity to help you navigate these challenges. Also, know that this is an incredible gift you have and be open to sharing your emotional stability and calm approach with others. If you are facing challenges, then the King of Cups is an indication that you must create balance in the realm of the emotions. The King of Cups represents compassion, one of the most powerful and beautiful qualities of the human spirit. Ask yourself, how can I develop a stronger awareness of the unconscious without being overwhelmed by its power? How can I develop a stronger sense of compassion without falling into the trap of sentimentality? The King of Cups encourages you to be considerate in your dealings with others and as you counsel others. You may need to understand why strong feelings have surfaced and how to best cope with them. It is important that you do not repress emotions but instead explore them with an open heart and an open mind. Sometimes, the King of Cups can represent an older male who may appear in your life. This card represents a man of business, law or divinity, who is kind, considerate and willing to take responsibility for his actions. He is paternalistic but in a sensitive, generous manner, and he enjoys the quiet power associated with providing loving energy to others. He is able to listen mindfully to others and he responds calmly in a crisis. He uses diplomacy rather than force, and reached out to help, not to stifle or have it only his way. Similarly, the King of Cups shows you generosity, graciousness, love, calmness, caring and will give you his healing ways. He has power in the business world and loves law and order. You would love him to be your doctor. If there were a crisis at hand, this is someone you would hope to have near. The King of Cups is highly diplomatic and politically correct. He has a real talent at being able to balance the needs of many people and keeps everyone working together harmoniously and productively. He knows how to show care and sensitivity as he leads others towards a common goal. He responds carefully to others' emotional needs and can diffuse a tense situation by reading and responding to the different people involved. Last but not least, the guidance card for you is the motivation. You drew this card because your motivation is changing, and what once interested you doesn't anymore. And what does interest you seems to be distracting you from your responsibilities. This card indicates that this pattern is stressful for you. Yet by facing the pattern, you are empowered to both understand and heal it. There's a need to deal with the boredom that has set in because of routines that no longer appeal to you. Sometimes it arises due to a desire for drama, to stir up excitement and variety. In order to recover your initial enthusiasm, it's often enough to discern the truth underlying why your motivation has flagged. Other times, boredom is a sign of burnout, which needs to be addressed directly or by heading in a new direction.
I hope that you enjoy everything, and if you like the reading, just please click subscribe and you will get instant notifications every time we publish a new video right to your YouTube. Thanks.